Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for joining us on Heart of Ohio Sports for this non-conference matchup between the Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains and the Mohawk Warriors, live from Bascom, Ohio at Hopewell-Loudon Stadium. We want to thank you for tuning in to the live stream and the Rodgers Flowers pregame show right here on Heart of Ohio Sports as we get ready to take it down for the national anthem. Nate Mullins, Tommy Hall on the call, bringing you all the live action on www.heartofohiosports.com. Subscribe and like our YouTube, Heart of Ohio Sports, and on our Facebook Live page. Like, share, let everybody know to join us on the call right here from Hopewell-Loudon as we get ready for, again, this huge non-conference matchup between two backyard rivals. And, Nate, we talk about those MAL ashes kind of rekindling here in 2022. Last week we opened up the season with Calvert versus Mohawk. Calvert able to upend Mohawk in that home contest at Frost Cownow Stadium. Mohawk tonight and Hopewell-Loudon looking to get on the win column, and it starts here in week two.
Here's the national anthem, courtesy of the Hopewell-Loudon Marching Band. Great job by the Hopewell-Loudon Marching Band, led by Jess Nelson. Tommy, I got to see Jess Nelson earlier today. He stopped in with a couple people and enjoyed some burgers at Madison Street Tavern.
Oh, absolutely. One of our fine sponsors as well. But you're enjoying the pregame show brought to you by Roger Flower, another great high school sponsor, bringing you high school athletics here on Heart of Ohio Sports. And Nate, once again, football week two already, week one already in the books, as we talked about at the top of the pregame. These two squads, Hopewell-Loudon and Mohawk, both looking to get into the win column. After last week, Hopewell-Loudon on the losing end in that effort against defending state champion Cary, and Mohawk, as we talked about, traveling to Tiffin to make that trek against the Calvert Senecas. Calvert coming on top in that one. So just
Eric Hall.
Once again, an unenviable task as these Mohawk Warriors begin their season, a part of this four-game stretch to start the 2022 campaign, Nate.
Absolutely right, Tommy. And we've got a packed house here in Bascom for this one. Once again, thanks for tuning in here on the Rodgers Flowers pregame show. We are just about set for kickoff. But Tommy, first, before we get into it, let's talk about these keys to the game. And of course, when we talk about keys to the game, we talk about Xcaret Mexican Restaurant in the Tiffin Mall. Boy, I tell you, I can't tell you enough about that place. Gorgeous atmosphere, great people, and great food.
Oh, that's first and foremost. I mean, I get hungry just watching the great commercials and everything that Xcaret has done for us as being a great community-minded sponsor here on Heart of Ohio Sports. But, Nate, those keys to the game that you talked about, both teams looking to get in the win column. Hopewell-Loudon, the keys for them here tonight is to get that young quarterback, Chris, going, get him on the right track, because it was an unenviable task for him last week against that state champion defense of Cary. And in that contest, Chris, just 9 of 20 in passing for 116 yards and two interceptions. So that tells me a lot that defense was really getting after it, yeah, really getting some penetration, forcing the young quarterback to make mental miscues and bad throws on the road in that loss against Cary. So tonight, Hopewell-Loudon offensive line, and it all starts in the trenches, Nate. You got to shore up right that line, give Chris enough time to go through his progressions and make sound choices against this Mohawk defense that really struggled against the passing game last week.
Yeah.
Mohawk, their keys for tonight, they're going to have to come out and they're going to have to get this offense rolling as well, as they kind of played around with this two-quarterback system with and Bryce Hannum and Ben Bogner, both completing 13 of 34 passes for 150 yards. But we are underway with this one as the kick goes out of bounds to start this one. So the Chieftains will start out here with the ball with great field position to start this drive.
All right, let's check in with our sideline reporter, Eric Hall. Let's see how he sounds today. Maybe he sounds a little bit better today. Eric, how's it going down there?
Hey, we got the mic going. Can you hear me good today, Nate?
Hey, that sounds a lot better this week, man.
Hey, all right. That is awesome.
All right, glad to have you on board this week, Eric. We're going to get a lot from you this week because we're going to need it, all right?
All right, I'm here for you.
All right, we're set to go. First and 10, Hopewell. They start out at their own 35-yard line. Crease in the shotgun handoff. Hayden Welly off the left side. And he plows forward. Mr. Plow picks up about 3 yards there, up to the 38-yard line. I want to give a huge shout-out to Katina Steinmetz from Steinmetz Signs and Graphic, Inc. She was able to come out and bring our banner so that way we could set it up here and tell everybody where they can tune in, because I'll tell you, folks, we had some problems with our backdrop. Crease slings it out right side. That's complete. Up to the 50-yard line and inside Mohawk territory, down to the 47-yard line.
Yeah, Adam Crease on the reception after Hopewell-Loudon started this drive from their own 35, had good field position, and on the first play of the game. Moves the chains for the Chieftains.
Crease in the shotgun set, turns around, handoff, Welly up the middle. And he's got a little bit of running room, gets it up past the 45, up to about the 43-yard line, Hayden Welly.
And this will be a big year for Welly. I was taken back a little bit ago when you called his name on that first run because I swore he had already graduated. I mean, he is just a house.
And there's Welly once again on the carry. Off
big
the
as a
right
junior.
Side. And he plows his way forward to about the 38-yard line. Big Hayden Welly.
And as he has so aptly been named in his junior campaign, Mr. Plow, plowing ahead for those additional second chance yards that really become all that important, especially at this level, because what that does for you, especially on second down, makes it easier to convert in those third and short, as Hopo now, third and two from the 39.
Pistol set, handoff to Welly off the left side. He's got some running room. He's out to the 30, to the 25, and he's tripped up past the 25 to the 23-yard line. Hayden Welly on the carry picks up plenty of yardage to pick up that first down. He only needed 3 yards, but he got about 13 there.
That was a great job by that Hopewell-Loudon interior. They got some big guys.
There. Number 3, Wyatt Crow, sophomore. Switched positions this year, playing some tight end. It's good to see. Another former Eagle there. Crease, shotgun, takes the snap off the left side. Actually, that is Braylon Martinez on the carry.
Nice job by the secondary and Mohawk. Stretching that play, allowing those linebackers to get to him. After Mohawk loaded the box on that one, Nate.
So a little bit of a dual quarterback look here as Martinez comes in now. Takes off for a 2-yard gain up to about the 22-yard line. .9:29 left here in the first quarter. No score. Handoff. Off the right side, that's Martinez on a little bit of a jet sweep look. And he's going to pick up a couple yards, up to about the 20, maybe the 19-yard line.
Kyle Stillbrigger for the Warriors in on the stop. The 6-foot, 190-pound senior Also, our cover athlete this week on our Heart of Ohio Sports promotional material, Nate.
Yeah, the Heart of Ohio Sports poster for the player or for the game this week. Kreese slings it out left side, completes it to his receiver, but it's going to be short of the first down. You're going to have fourth and about two, maybe three here.
And I tell you what, Hopewell-Loudon, they did a tremendous job moving this ball between the 20s, but right here in the red zone, this is where Mohawk Warrior defense is really played. This is where Mohawk football is actually played, Nate. Of course, Mohawk turned away on four attempts from the red zone last week. And Willie.
First down and a touchdown. Hayden Welly takes off from the 16-yard line and plows his way into the end zone, breaking tackles along the way.
Mr. Plow, that's his name. That name again is Mr. Plow. With the first touchdown of this one, as the Chieftains able to draw first blood with 8-11 here to the first stanza of action. Live from Bascom, Ohio, you're watching this game on Heart of Ohio Sports. Tune in on our YouTube page, like and subscribe at Heart of Ohio Sports, along on our Facebook Live. Like, subscribe, share, spread the message. Heart of Ohio Sports is live as Hopewell-Loudon is going to go for two. Kreese, I think. Yet. Turns it up and able to get the two-point conversion as Braylon Martinez there. And at this level, Nate, that 8-0 lead can make all the difference because you don't really have a assured kicking game, an assured extra point unit here in this division. And so sometimes, you know, again, you see a lot of games decided by that 1-2 point differential. So when you go for it on two, you better convert because you might need that extra point down the line.
Absolutely. So a big drive there from Hopewell-Loudon as they're able to march it down the field and punch it in on their first possession of the ball game.
Don't forget, we'll have the fallout from week two after tonight's contest. And over on the Xtreme, our new YouTube channel, you can also catch Calvert versus Monroeville. But again, the fallout from week two, all to be covered this Monday night on the Pulse podcast, live from the Heart of Ohio Sports studio at 193 South Washington Street. We love snail mail, ladies and gentlemen. And Hopewell-Loudon kicks off as it's going to be fielded right around the 26 by Mohawk's Nicholas Golig.
It'll start out right about the 36-yard line.
We'll see for the Warriors in that press release. Well done by the Heart of Ohio Sports Observer. I'll get it out eventually. The Heart of Ohio Sports Observer with Josh Morgrit. You know, that was what they kind of highlighted here with this Mohawk offense. Eric Daniels said in preseason he wasn't married to a one quarterback system, and it didn't take long for him to put Bed Bogner in. This Zayden Fry. Coming out with the run, and if you've ever watched Mohawk football, they don't they ain't trying to play games. You know, it's going to be straight up the gut all night for 48 minutes.
Yeah, you're going to get everything they got.
Trevor Johnson goes in motion to the other side of the quarterback.
Bogner rolls to the left, gets away from pressure. Slings it down the field, and he's got it to his receiver at the 34-yard line. What a catch there by Zayden Fry.
And what a move by Bogner. As they, once again, they put Trevor Johnson in motion, brought him to the other hip.
Oh, we got a flag Bogner. Down. Hang on, there's some laundry.
Might be a block in the back, maybe, or normally it's a hold. And it is going to be on the Warriors. So after a tremendous heads-up play by Bogner to extend it and move the chain for the Warriors and a huge reception, all going to be taken away. That's what you love to see out of Bogner, especially here in week two. Flushed out of the pocket, trying to extend the play. Could have tucked it up and ran, but looked for the open man downfield. Went through his, looked for the hot read. Hopewell-Loudon comes out in that 4-4. Really have some big trust up front with these heavies to get pressure. Eric Hostler, number 52, in on the tackle for the Chieftains there. He's on that 4th and 11. Mohawk forced a punt, and the ball will land right around the 34. And that's exactly where Hopewell-Loudon will start this drive. Had to make a quick battery change on our scoreboard there.
There we go. All right. And we're back.
Still in the first stanza.
Thanks for keeping it go, Tom. Yeah.
That's the great thing about television. You can just watch.
That's right.
6:22 in this first stanza of action. That's Willie up the gut. No, that is Willie. The sun reflected off his bicep, and I was handy for sure.
8-0 Hopewell-Loudon. 6 minutes to play here in the first quarter. Chieftains have it at their own 34-yard line. Second down and 8. Evan Creese in the shotgun. Two receivers on the near side of the field, one on the far side.
Mohawk
fake the handoff, now sling it out right side. He's got it complete up to Braylon Martinez, and Martinez has it up near the first down marker. Should be good enough to move those chains.
And Braylon Martinez, believe it or not, just in his sophomore campaign, had a lot of reps, a lot of snaps his freshman campaign. And, man, you talk about playing beyond your years. The football IQ of Martinez just through the roof.
Now, do you think he fills that role that Sharon Jones left behind?
Big shoes to fill. But
yeah, I was going to say.
You know, that's
champ.
What I love about Hopewell-Loudon is Coach Collar truly always the year. He always always exposes them strengths and hides the negatives.
Welly on the carry. Has it up inside enemy territory.
Down I don't know what they've seen in that.
49. We got a flag that flies in at the end of the play. I think you're going to get a block in the back here on number 2, Lake Barrier. They're going to wave it off. I thought he got him by the shoulder. I didn't think I seen the back, so. Heads up call there by the umpire crew.
Yeah, and you can't thank these officials enough for coming out here tonight.
Absolutely.
And refereeing this game. As, you know, a lot of teams, especially at this division, a lot of teams around the area having games moved to Saturdays for the lack of officials. So, just once again, big shout out to the officials and the guys that put in the time to come out there and take the heat.
Welly on the carry. Gets it up. Past the first down marker, but a flag flies in. We'll see what the call is here.
Still won't win you any favors throwing that laundry out there. Or that microphone.
Eric, you might want to let the referee use your sideline mic down there. Sounds like he needs it.
Well, not the direction the Chieftains were hoping to go as they continue to this drive with the ball on the 41 on 2nd and 12.
Crease slings it out right side, complete. Martinez past midfield. He's got the first down.
And we talk about that football IQ, Nate. If you're going to leave Martinez on an island, he's going to make you pay for it. He's going to find that soft spot in the zone and make you pay.
Absolutely right.
The only way to counter that is, again, to either switch up to man and start bringing some pressure. Hopewell-Loudon gets it all back off that huge reception.
First and 10, Chieftains. Ball at the 41. Got 4:25 left to play here in the first.
They go from the 41 to the 41.
That's exactly what happened. Fake the handoff. Martinez is going to keep it up the middle.
Oh.
Nice running there by Braylon Martinez as he found that little crease there, Tommy.
Thought
not
he was
Evan
a quarterback.
Crease either.
Evan or Adam, not that crease. And thus far, with 4 minutes remaining and rolling here in the first quarter, Hopewell-Loudon is looking pretty polished after that week one dispatching by Carey. Up 8-0 here.
Welly. Hand off the left side. Whoa. He's got it up past the 30, up to the 29-yard line, but a flag flies in at the end of the play here.
I tell you what, that was a heck of an effort by Braden Chester for Mohawk, coming in off the backside to make that stop, chasing Welly down, but off or not, as it looked like it might be a clip.
Yep, clipping.
Cut.
Oh, come on. Cut it out. Once again, thanks for tuning in here on the Adrenaline Stream here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Of course, the X Stream. Yeah, you heard that right. The X Stream.
You're listening to the A Stream.
Our partner crew. Zach Dillon.
Greg Kinn.
And Connor Roush.
Calling a tremendous game from Frost County Stadium in this in our backyard as Calvert leads right now 14-0 over
That's
Monroeville.
Right. Great start for the Senecas there. Evan Crease rolls to his right, slings it out. He's got it out complete up to the 35-yard line and out of bounds. Nice job on the reception there by Blake Barrier.
Huge chunk yardage once again that these Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains have been able to open up. And that's what makes your offense scary, Nate, is when you can give some relief to your running back and Whaley because you know that they're just going to let the big hoss out of his cage.
Yeah.
Let the bull out of the pen. But in this case, once you find some success in the passing game,
Crease going to take off.
Keeps the defense humble as Crease takes off, keeps it.
Nice job there by Trevor Johnson tackling in space.
But you're danged if you do, danged if you don't, if you're Coach Eric Daniels in this Mohawk defense, keeping them humble.
Down inside of 3 minutes to play here in the first quarter. Still 8-0 Hopewell. They have the possession driving into enemy territory now. Shotgun formation, two receivers on each side of the formation. Welly in motion. And they sling it out right side to Hayden Welly. He
that
drops
be
it, and I think that's going to be a fumble.
That yeah,
is a
it
fumble.
Is a fumble.
And
Mohawk
jumps on the ball. They have possession. Braden Chester.
Yeah, I got a little worried when I seen Welly get out in open space. I was like, he's too far out if you're going to just pitch that. Hoping that the pass went forward, but it didn't. It just kind of lateraled behind him.
I think he probably is a little guilty of looking upfield on that one, Tommy, because there was about two or three Warriors starting to close in there in the flat. They read that play pretty well, They were ready to sniff it out, but
they're not used to getting them type of receptions, you know. Welly, if he gets the rock, he's going to tuck it up under that armpit with that, like a big stiff loaf of bread.
Yeah. Bogner on the quarterback keeper, right side. And he's got it up to about the, maybe a yard past the line of scrimmage.
And it was almost at will as Hopewell-Loudon was putting together a very successful drive after being able to get on the scoreboard first.
Yeah.
8-0 over Mohawk. Mohawk, again, counting their blessings after that huge turnover, gives them a little bit of sigh of relief. But you got to do something with it here because this Hopewell-Loudon defense isn't going to give you too many opportunities.
That's absolutely right. Bogner back to pass in the pocket. Slings it over the middle. Ooh. Incomplete as he was looking for Nicholas Goling.
I don't know what Goling was doing getting tied up with the linebacker there. And Noah Kubitz.
Yeah, he did a pretty good job in coverage there, just facing the receiver and preventing him from getting to the ball.
His Goling was like, get out of my way. This big mass of man in front of me. Oh, it's Kubitz here. Yeah, about he's a 5'10", 210 pounds. All man in the yard wide.
Third and long. Bogner in the shotgun takes the snap. Drops back, looking, slings it down the middle of the field. Incomplete. He was looking for Zayden Fry, but just overthrows his intended receiver. And that's going to bring out the punt unit. Fourth and long now for Mohawk.
Well, when you're first forced into those third and distance situations like that, Nate, third and a mile, you want to turn to your guy like Zayden Fry, one of your taller receivers on the squad at 6'1", 175 pounds, because you can put the ball up a little higher because he's going to usually have that reach advantage over the guy defending him. But that one was just too much mustard. As Mohawk was gifted the turnover, failed to do anything with it. And now Martinez, look at the setup shot right where they started.
Blake Barrier on the return. And he's got it up past the 40-yard line.
Did not say this starts from the 41.
Actually, they'll say he's right at the 40. Yep, 41, 42, somewhere around in there. Great job up on the return by Barrier. What a return.
At 42, so where the Hopewell-Loudon drive stalled on their last possession, resulting in that turnover. They will now take over for this drive and try to go to work and finish what they started on their last. Ball on the 42, a minute 28 to go here in the first quarter.
Hand off Hayden Welly. And defense is right there to make the stop, right at the line of scrimmage. Nice job getting back there by Braylon Mulholland.
And Stillberger, I mean, you're starting to bring some of those Warriors up.
Shotgun set, second and long. Martinez, the quarterback now, keeps it. And he's got it up past the 40, up to about the 38-yard line. Good for four. Third and about seven coming up.
Tenacious is this Mohawk defense. They're starting. You can't allow frustration to turn into miscues.
That's right.
If you're Mohawk, you know, again, you weren't able to do anything on that gifted turnover. Your defense is forced to march right back out there. But, again, you just continue to test your mettle here inside your own territory. And Mohawk had the chance at it.
Nice job.
Almost resulted in another turnover. There's Caleb Bish on the coverage. Forces this to go to a fourth and seven. As that's going to be it for the first quarter of action, live here from Bascom, Ohio. Nate Mullins, Tommy Hall on the call, and we want to thank you for joining us for that first quarter of action here on Heart of Ohio Sports.
Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, your premier financial institution in Seneca County since 1952. Your community, your legacy. Federally insured NCUA.
Small business owners need somebody that can open the door to financing. And at First National Bank of Sycamore, we love opening the door for financing opportunities.
And we're back here. Start of the second quarter. Punt goes off the helmet of a Chieftain. And it will be downed right at the 5, but they'll say that's going to go all the way back to about the 17-yard line where it hit him on the helmet. We'll take a moment and thank all of our sponsors for bringing you today's ball game right here on the pulse of the Buckeye State, heart of Ohio sports. Thanks to Rodgers Flowers, TPC Food Service, Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, MST Sauce Company, Phillips Electric, Xcaret Mexican Restaurant, First National Bank of Sycamore, Steinmetz Signs and Graphic Inc., Benchwarmers Restaurant and Delivery, TJ Willie's Fine Foods, Feasel's Frame and Collision, Reno's Pizza and Pasta, Sara Risen, Century 21 Bolte and Tiffin, Embroidery and Crafts by Busia, Buckeye IT, Linda Ritzler Accounting, Culligan Water, Five Star Maintenance, short gain there by the Warriors, and we'll finish out the list here, Champs Barbershop and the Advertiser-Tribune. A huge shout out to all of those sponsors here on Heart of Ohio Sports.
Scoreless first quarter for the Warriors as they had their backs against the wall three times in that first quarter against this Hopewell-Loudon high-powered offense. But the last two drives for Hopewell-Loudon resulting in a turnover. Hopewell-Loudon on their last drive forced a punt after a 3rd-and-9 situation was incomplete.
Sling it out right side and a short gain by Zayden Fry. As all over that one was Jagger Endicott.
But thus far, like we talked about, scoreless for the Warriors as they just haven't been able to get anything going offensively. We've seen some nice looks, some nice plays out of Bogner, but we're starting little penalties, little things erase and can end your drive so quickly.
Big third and long here for Mohawk. 3rd-and-12. Ball at about the 15-yard line. Bogner rolls to the left. Looking, slings it down the field, and it is out of bounds. He took a hit as he got rid of that one.
Very reminiscent of the way the Hopewell-Loudon drive ended there as Mohawk will be forced to punt here.
In there applying the pressure was Aiden Fitro. 6'1", 250-pound junior. Now he's been in the backfield a lot tonight already. And now the punt unit comes out of the field.
You got to get
Braden
a good
Chester
punt off here.
Chester, a low line drive. That's going to hit off the turf. And wisely, Martinez just covers it up. Falls right on top of it. You know, he's an electric returner, but Barrier just decided, you know what? I'm not going to take any chances here. I'm not going to let it eat me up. I'm just going to fall right on top of this thing. He just swallowed it up, and Chieftains will take over at the Mohawk 46.
It doesn't get any easier for the Warriors here as they're going to try to stop this high-powered offense of Hopewell-Loudon starting out in their own territory. Hopewell-Loudon now looking to finish a drive after coming out and opening up the scoring 8-0 lead.
See if we can check in with our sideline guy here after this play. Eric Hall down there on the sideline. Welly on a big carry gets that one up. handoff up the middle. Short gain.
You know, you can draw up all your trick plays, have your fun, but there ain't nothing that's ever going to just stop good old-fashioned ground and pound, nose to the stone football like Hayden Willie, a 6'1", 220-pound running back for you. Pretty ball thrown up for grabs along the sidelines. Zayden Fry on the coverage.
Going for Blake Barrier.
Blake
down
Barrier trying to haul it in. Beautiful ball thrown there.
Hopefully we can get our sideline guy in sometime here. Welly on the handoff carries that one forward for about a four-yard gain.
Don't forget, if you're watching this game online, we do encourage you to go over to our website if you're looking for live updates of other scores from around the area as a we're covering this one between Hopewell-Loudon and Mohawk. And then over on the X-Stream, Greg Kinn and Zach Dillon covering Calvert versus Monroeville. But we also have the score stream set up on our website.
Sling it out left side. Martinez on the reception.
Well, we're focused on the great action that you're finding here on Heart of Ohio Sports. We circled the best matchups in Northwest Ohio, Nate.
That's right. All right, let's send it down to our sideline guy. I think Eric has a little bit better reception now. He can hear us a little better. Let's see if we can hear him. Eric, how's it going down there?
Hey, we're going good. I can hear you great now.
Hey, and I can actually hear you pretty good. So this is your first chance to get an up-close and personal look at senior running back Hayden Welly. I mean, you talk about a man playing playing a game right now. What's your impression of this kid? Yeah, you're too far away. You're just a little too far away there, Eric. I always told Greg, when we're at this stadium, you got to stay inside the 20s. All right. So second down and six here. Shotgun formation. Two receivers on the far side of the field. Wing back on the left side. Fake the handoff. Crease rolls to his right. Slings it out. It's complete. Martinez with a great catch. Inside the 10, down to about the 8-yard line.
And even though Hopewell-Loudon leading here 8-0 and these continuous drives, the one thing I do feel is a little hot cold on this offense is they seem to get some drives put together, get the play calling right, and then they have to make it up on third and long situations. Yeah. It's like if these guys can string together a consistent drive with a mixture of both, like you're seeing here.
Welly on the handoff carries it forward, and he's got it inside the 5 down to about the 3-yard line.
This Chieftain squad will be something difficult to deal with in weeks to come. You're seeing the gel process right now.
Handoff. Welly, left side, plows forward. And he's got it down to about the 3-yard line.
Hayden Welly doing the gel process, turning defender legs to jelly as lays the wood. See Hopewell-Loudon in that unique formation.
Two receivers out far to the right. Two tight ends on the right side of the formation. Actually, one on each side of the formation. Direct snap to Welly. He buries his head forward, and he's going to be down just shy of the goal line. So we got a fourth down coming up here. Fourth and about a yard to go. You know they're keeping that offense on the field, Tommy. Now, last year in these situations, I mean, it was pretty obvious what was going to happen. You just give the ball to 32. You need those 2 yards? Get him.
Yeah, this is definitely a gut check. Check your manhood here as a lot of big games have been decided right here on the goal line. Fourth and one. Welly, met at the line, but I think he's going to be able to pull ahead. And the Chieftains get on the board as Welly was stood up right at the line, kept those legs churning. And boys and girls, again, if you want to see a running back clinic, if you're a youth football player tuning in, Hayden Welly, that's your guy to watch.
Well, I'll tell you, Tommy, if you're watching film, you better hope you're at least 220 pounds because not many people run like that.
Not
at 220
pounds.
Because not many people are that big. I mean.
Not at 220 pounds.
The nimble feet of the senior running back on display here today as Chieftains now ahead 14-0 and now onto the field here for the two-point conversion. Kreese takes the snap, looking,
ooh,
slings it left side, complete. Endicott on the reception, and he's going to be short.
Nice read
he
by
won't
the
get there. Nice job by the defense.
Well, now is your traditional two-possession game.
Yes.
14-0. 5:50 remaining in the first half, and we can't thank you enough for joining us right here on Heart of Ohio Sports, the adrenaline stream. Don't forget, we also got two channels playing right now as well on our website, www.heartofohiosports.com, and YouTube, the X Stream. You can catch Heart of Ohio Sports' X Stream coverage of Calvert versus Monroeville. As last we knew, Calvert was leading that one 14-0.
Yeah, it's 20-0 now in the second quarter. Score update from Tiffin Columbian as they are at Springfield today. 27-9 is the score. Tornadoes on top of the Blue Devils. That's in Holland, Springfield. Big drive there by the Chieftains. Two out of their three offensive possessions have led to touchdowns.
Yeah, and Mohawk, given the opportunities early on to right those wrongs, but this offense just hasn't come out of the gate yet for the Warriors.
A squib kick here. Actually, I think that was a little bit of an onside kick attempt there. Maybe trying to get the ball back.
Well, here's the thing is, once you get this Hopewell-Loudon squad clicking, you get this offense rolling, you're up two scores, this is the time to put your foot on the pedal.
Yeah.
Try to bury opponents early. It throws you off your game plan to where, again, you're trying to make up drives, and you can't continuously do that, especially if you're Mohawk. You get the ball at great field position to start on the 47. Make something happen with it.
Let's take a look around the area at the First National Bank of Sycamore scoreboard. We'll do that right after this play. Shotgun set. Bogner takes the snap. He's going to keep it left side. He's looking for some running room.
He's met right there at the line, though.
Great job by that Hopewell defensive line as they swallow him up and drive him backwards. But he did pick up a couple yards there. Good for two up to the 49.
And Will Nutter, tremendous job. Been a cog. And this defensive line, just in his sophomore campaign, 6'3", 230 pounds. And I said, it's just a sophomore. This boy's got time to grow.
Three receivers on the near side, one on the far side of the field, second down and 8. Bogner drops back to pass, rolls to his right, looking, keeps rolling.
Chieftains bringing the pressure.
Slings it down the field, and nobody home. Bogner trying to make something happen here. There's just nothing there in coverage. We got a flag, though, right around the 40-yard line. Actually, is that a flag or what is that? It is a flag. And we have a penalty against the Chieftains here. That's going to be a first down. It's like a pass interference or something. Maybe a holding, defensive holding. I think that's what the call was. So the ball will be placed at the 41-yard line. Mohawk has it, first and 10 inside Hopewell territory. 5:01 to play here in the first half. Bogner back to pass, looking. Slings it across the middle,
nice.
Complete. He's got it to Zayden Fry. Fry makes a man miss, and it's going to be brought down right around the 29-yard line.
And all Fry has ever asked for was a chance with it, because once he gets the ball in his possession, he can make things happen. But is that another more laundry?
That's more laundry on the field.
So now we're going back.
Yeah, that'll set them backwards. We'll mark that one all the way back.
Man, marching off some yards.
What did the holding call occur at the 50-yard line? Wow.
Ooh. All right, looking about first and a mile.
First down and about 28. Bogner is going to get sacked in the backfield.
Make that more.
For a loss back to the 35-yard line.
5-yard loss. I believe that's Braylon Smith. And Aiden Petro going to share a sack lunch there. That's why I always pack four sandwiches in case you want one.
That's right. Third, second down and long. Second and 34. Slings it out, right side. That's Bryce Hanum on the reception. And Hanum's got it up to about the 40-yard line. So they'll get about seven back. But still, third and very long.
I ever tell you how much I hate those like little bubble screens, because they look like they get nothing done. But in reality, again, turns out about 6 yards just because you got to wait for the defense to come and pursue and get over to the play to make that stop. But it's never designed to break, you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. We'll send it down to our sideline reporter after this play here. Bogner going to try to run. Takes the left side.
Oh, he's
going to
be met.
And he is
Will Nutter
followed up in the backfield for a loss. And that'll bring out the punt unit for Mohawk with 2:54 left to play here in the first half.
Well, on a huge third and 27, Will Nutter shows his bread and butter, brings down the quarterback in a huge loss of yards here as Mohawk going to be forced to punt after having this drive to start right around the 47-yard line, Nate.
Yeah.
Now punting from your own 38.
Braden Chester with the punt gets it away. That's going to take a friendly roll all the way inside the 15.
Well, at least you flipped the field here.
Down to the 13-yard line. Nice job there by Chester.
Now, if you're Mohawk, you know, two-possession game, not the biggest lead in the world, but with 2:21 remaining here in this first half, Nate, this defensive stand, you know, you hate having to call upon them to get things done, but the defense is going to have to show out tonight. That's going to be the difference for Mohawk. You can't continuously allow this offense to cut you up.
Man, Eric, I see you standing down there, and, you know, you're standing – next to these guys on the sideline, and these kids are just absolutely mammoths. What's it like? Can you even see over these kids to see the play right now?
No. I can't see the play right now. Yeah, there's some big guys down here.
Kreese slings it out left side. That is incomplete. Intended for Blake Barrier. Boy, those uniforms are clean, though, aren't they? I just love that red, the gray look with the white outline. Numbers so easy to see. Of course, Mohawk. Gotta love those clean whites. Kreese rolls to his right, second down and long, and that one's incomplete.
Another tip pass by the Warrior defense as Braden Chester. Another tremendous read.
Nice job there by Chester, knocking that one down. 2:10 to play here in the first half. 14-0 Hopewell-Loudon. Chieftains have possession here with a third and long coming up. Ball at their own 14.
You think a guy like Braden Chester, 6'1", 210-pound, the way they play him, that you would think he was almost an extra defensive back, but they kind of bring him down in kind of that inside linebacker, outside linebacker situation, depending on what defense they're running.
Crease back to pass, third and long. Yeah. Looks over the middle. It's complete. He's got it up to his man, and they've got the first down up to the 30-yard line. That's Braylon Martinez on the reception.
In that zone that a guy like Chester is notorious for covering, the Warriors bring Chester in on the blitz, and that read was there. Allows for the Chieftains to get a fresh set of downs here.
Slings it out right side. Incomplete. Intended for number seven, Adam Crease.
Sometimes it's only week two. You still go through your reps. You still continuously add to your wheelhouse. And at game speed, you know, these plays, some of them are a little slow to develop. Some of them are a little bit too quick. In that instance, just a little bit too quick there as you – when that play starts coming together, it's going to come together nicely, Nate.
Yeah. And that's, you know, early season stuff.
Yeah,
you know,
that's what I said.
You'll work that out. Crease, second and long, rolls to his right, gets it out complete to Barrier. Barrier on the reception, has it up past midfield, and carries a couple of Mohawk defenders up to the 49-yard line.
Man, that's not like talking about or standing on any soapbox, but with the limited contact in today's game,
that's absolutely
just at
right.
practice, doing this at game speed, at game tempo is a whole different story, man. It's called varsity speed.
1:29 to play, first and 10. Crease slings it right side, and that's complete. Coverage on the play by Ethan Gatchell, but a nice job on the reception by Barrier.
Pitter patter, get right at her as the Chieftains now. Second and five here. Easy down to convert.
Second down and five for this Chieftain offense here. 1:22 left to play in the first half. They lead 14-0. Crease takes the snap, looking, slings it.
That's a long
left
ball.
Left side, and Zayden Fry almost had his hands on that one, nearly picked it off. Nice coverage there on the play. But we got a flag on the field right around the 45-yard line, right around the line of scrimmage. Usually that indicates holding, but we'll see what the call is.
What a way for Crease to throw that one up over top.
Yeah.
The defenders, I mean, it was definitely a gamble, but.
And you needed an athletic player like Fry to go up there and make that play on the ball. Otherwise, he'd have dropped that right in the bucket, Tommy.
Yeah, you could imagine that. Could you imagine that catch and step?
Ah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. Fry had to kind of, the receiver had to kind of turn back for it.
Shotgun set. Crease takes the snap, ooh, slings it out left side. They set up the screen.
And the Mohawk
into the open
pit.
Field down to the 39-yard line. Jagger Endicott on the reception.
And with under almost with a minute and 7 seconds left here in the first half, both squads with three timeouts might be wise to call one as Hopewell-Loudon continuing to roll. And if you're Eric Daniels, you can't take those with you.
Down inside of a minute to play.
Get quick to the ball.
Sling it out left side, and that one's incomplete, intended for Endicott. 52 seconds left here. So a second down and 10 coming up.
52 seconds left here, Nate. 14-0. Chieftains on top. You got to believe the Warriors just looking to get out of the half here. Get those adjustments made.
Yeah. Down to 52 seconds left here in the first half. Chieftains leading 14-0. They are driving right to left here. Evan Kreese rolls to his right, slings it out, and it's complete. Endicott into the open. 10-5, touchdown, Hopewell-Loudon. From 35 yards out.
And the linchpin to the balloon of Mohawk's game plan here in the first half just popped there.
Yeah.
As, again, less than a minute to go. You just try not to give up a touchdown. You down two possessions. You go into the locker room. You can make those adjustments. Say, hey, you know, Hopewell started the game off with the ball. We come out with the ball, make a statement, make something happen. It's a brand-new ball game. But another Chieftain touchdown right before we go to the half puts the Chieftains up 21-0 as we're live here from Bascom, Ohio on Heart of Ohio Sports.
Big time drive there by the Chieftains. They go up by three scores now before the halftime period. Let's send it down to our sideline reporter, Eric Hall, as he's got the weather report for us. Eric, how's the weather looking down there today, man?
Beautiful night for football.
Oh, it is a beautiful Friday night for football. And I studied that under my notes now. We got a 70 degrees right now. We got no wind. I have the sunset here in about 25 minutes, and we're not going to lose. It's going to be an awesome Friday night for a second half.
Well, absolutely. Now, are you going to keep them sunglasses on when the sun goes down?
I got to keep them on right now because I can't see without these things on right now.
Yeah, Once again, thanks to Eric Hall, our sideline reporter. That's the weather report brought to you by your friends at Phillips Electric.
The sun overlooking the beautiful stadium here at Hopewell-Loudon.
Of course, Phillips Electric in downtown Tiffin is an authorized dealer of Whirlpool, Kenmore, and Maytag products as the Warriors bring it up to the 29-yard line. If you have any questions about any of their products or brands that they may service, feel free to call Greg and Tom Phillips at 419-447-3934. Simply stop by Phillips Electric, 176 South Washington Street in Tiffin. Tell them the great folks at Heart of Ohio Sports sent you in there. Because, folks, I'm telling you, when you go to these businesses that we tell you to go to, it really means a lot if you tell them, hey, watch that broadcast the other night. I saw your stuff on it. It means a lot. It means a lot more than you think.
It means a lot to us that they're allowing us to bring these games to you paywall free.
Absolutely right.
That's why we love our sponsors so much.
Bogner fakes the handoff, rolls to his left, slings it out.
Look at that.
Pass intercepted. What a play.
Oh, man.
Picked off by the Chieftains. Blake Barrier goes up and gets it. What a pick! Boy, Eric, you had a pretty good view at that one, man. I didn't know if he was going to get to that, but what a play by Blake Barrier.
Murphy's Law rearing its ugly head over there on the Warriors sideline as what could go
great
wrong.
Too. It was right on the money, but it just great coverage by Hopewell there.
Has here tonight.
Up the middle. Kreese takes off and runs and picks up the first down. And a timeout called by Hopewell-Loudon as they've got it inside Mohawk territory at the 49-yard line.
And that's your decision. That's such a tough decision, too, Nate. Less than 30 seconds ago, hope you give the turnover. Hopewell-Loudon looking to start another drive. You dial up the pressure to try to get a stop for a loss or get a sack or do something to throw this Hopewell-Loudon offense off rhythm. And then you just allow a huge gain. And now Hopewell-Loudon calls that timeout as you've opened up a whole new playbook for them.
Yeah, absolutely. Folks, don't forget to stick around for the halftime show brought to you by TPC Food Service. Of course, for 75 years, TPC Food Service in Tiffin, Ohio has been providing quality product and service to food service operators in Northwest Ohio and the surrounding area. Family owned and Ohio proud. Contact them toll free at 1-800-342-0477 today. TPC Food Service, big enough to serve you, small enough to care.
Yeah, they deliver my groceries. That's how big they are.
You would get your groceries from a food distributor.
Yeah, TPC.
I knew Charlotte was eating a lot.
Just couldn't be more excited to get them on board from the onset of Heart of Ohio Sports. So we want to thank them for investing and joining in on this vision of helping you bring high school athletics to everybody here in Northwest Ohio.
And they sling it down left side. It is complete. Down to the 28-yard line.
And Jagger Endicott lowers the shoulder, lowers the boom. I'm gonna spike it here. If he doesn't, fumbles the snap, picks it back up, then spikes it.
They're saying the quarterback fumbled the ball, picked it up, and then threw it. So that is intentional grounding by the rule. I guess. I don't know. That's news to me. I don't know. I've never heard that before.
But. I mean, you can't, on a regular play, you can't fumble the snap and then just throw it to nobody. In that case, they tried to spike it. Kind of the same line of thinking.
Crease, back to pass. Over the middle, incomplete.
Ooh, that one just takes a nosedive into the dirt.
Down to 3 seconds left. And we're going to get a third and long here. Last play of the first half. And let's see what the Chieftains draw up here. These are the kind of plays that Brian Calatrullio is known for here. You got, you know,
you look at
one
this
play.
As a free play?
You need one play. This is the kind of coach you want in this situation, you know?
Yeah, that coach that can come up with that one
that's
play.
Right. They can draw it up in the dirt. And receivers all on the right side. They sling it down the field, crease. Oh, they come up with the reception, but he's just short at the 2-yard line. What a catch by Jagger Endicott, but. They come up just short of the end zone. That'll be it for the first half. Your score, 21-0, Hopewell-Loudon. We're going to step aside. We'll take a timeout. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after this with the TPC Food Service Halftime Show on Heart of Ohio Sports.
Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, your premier financial institution in Seneca County since 1952. Your community, your legacy. Federally insured NCUA.
Small business owners need somebody that can open the door to financing. And at First National Bank of Sycamore, we love opening the door for financing opportunities.
Yeah. And we're back here at Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains Stadium. Nate Mullins, Tommy Hall on the call. Folks, we are going to take a momentary timeout. We'll come back when there's about 5 minutes until the start of the second half. But while we're gone, please enjoy at least the visual of the marching band, because until we figure out this copyright thing and the fact that they need to shut down our stream if they hear copyrighted music, well, until then, we just can't show you the audio. So enjoy the video of the marching band. Thanks,
we'll
folks.
Be back with we'll the right TPC back. Food Service Halftime Show. Go over everything with you. And don't forget, tune in now. Share it on Facebook. Like and subscribe to our YouTube. Don't forget the X-Stream as well on our second YouTube page, Aaron Calvert versus Monroeville. But you're tuned in right here to Heart of Ohio Sports, Calvert or Mohawk versus Hopewell-Loudon live from Bascom, Ohio.
We'll be right back after this. Don't go anywhere. All right. Welcome back, folks. We're here for the halftime show brought to you by, of course, your friends at TPC Food Service. Nate Mullins, Tommy Hall on the call. We've got Eric Hall down on the sidelines. And we've got my son, Bailey Mullins, manning the cameras today. Thanks for tuning in here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Tommy, what an exciting first half if you are a Chieftains fan. Big time explosion on the offensive side of the ball. And even a couple turnovers on the defensive side of the ball as well. So they are really playing all elements of this game to their strengths.
Yeah, Hopewell-Loudon definitely is in a feeling out process of themselves, finding their identity. We go on and on, drone on and on at the top of the pregame about getting dispatched by state champion Kerry. You know, in that respect, like we talked about, when you're a young Krius coming out there, taking over the quarterback duties, you know, what a challenge it was for him week one to go against a very stout defense in that Kerry squad. But, you know, coming into tonight, now you're starting to see this offense finally get some rhythm, start gelling together. And they just poured it on Mohawk there in that first half. They hope allowed him again in that feeling out process, you know, trying to establish their identity. The couple turnovers that they gave Mohawk continuous bites of the apple, but it's actually turned around to bite Mohawk in the you-know-what after they failed to turn turnovers into points, Nate, as you always hound on. You know, that's what you got to do.
Points off turnovers. Yep. It's a huge stat.
Hopewell-Loudon, again, was able to put some great impressive drives that resulted in turnovers, but more importantly, resulted in 21 points as they lead here at the half.
Absolutely right. We're going to take a time to thank all of our sponsors for bringing you high school football right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Thanks to Rodgers Flowers, TPC Food Service, Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, MST Sauce Company, Phillips Electric, Xcaret Mexican Restaurant, First National Bank of Sycamore, Steinmetz Signs and Graphic Inc. A huge shout out to Katina Steinmetz for bringing our banner here today. I spaced and forgot to grab it on the way out of town. I can't thank her enough for bringing it to us. Huge shout out to Benchwarmers Restaurant and Delivery, the host of our show, The Coach's Corner. You'll find that on Tuesdays right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Also, thanks to TJ Willie's Fine Foods, Feasel's Frame and Collision, Reino's Pizza and Pasta, Sara Risen, Century 21 Bolte and Tiffin, Embroidery and Crafts by Busia, Buckeye IT, Linda Ritzler Accounting, Culligan Water, Five Star Maintenance, Champs Barbershop, and the Advertiser-Tribune, all proud sponsors right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Add a few new sponsors this week. We're just going to keep adding to the list because, folks, I'm telling you, everybody wants to get on board with us. And if you want to get on board, hey, there's one way to do it. Get a hold of us, hosbroadcasting@gmail.com.
We're underway. Short kit to begin the second half as Mohawk will try to take over and make something happen to open up this first half of action. As the Chieftains really were on top, we didn't really get to touch on it much in the halftime show, but there to start off things on a 4th and 2, Hopewell-Loudon able to put points on the board. 2-point conversion was good, put Hopewell up 8-0. Then once again, Chieftains go for it on 4th down, this time from the 1-yard line, get on the board again to make it 14-0.
Fumbled the snap there. Bogner tried to grab it, but luckily the Warriors fall on top of it. They'll lose a yard there. 2nd down and 11 coming up.
Hayden
Rough
Welly,
start for these Warriors here.
He's just been a bruiser here tonight. 2 touchdowns on the night. Counting for 12 of those 21 points here. Mohawk looking to get on the board here in the second half.
A handoff now, right side. Nothing doing there as Trevor Johnson was trying to find some running room, but there was nothing there for him. We'll have to check in with our sideline reporter, Eric Hall. Eric, I want to open up the floor here for you. If you see anything down there, you want to chime in, man, feel free. You go right ahead. I want you to feel like I got to send it down to you every time. So, hey, if you see something, go ahead. Bogner back to pass. Looking over the middle. Complete. He's got it. Zayden Fry. And Fry has it past the first down marker. That is a big-time conversion there for the Mohawk Warriors.
Nice job.
Third and 11, they pick up 12.
Yeah, nice job by that offensive line, giving the quarterback time to go check through his progressions, find the open man, and make one heck of a conversion on a huge down and distance situation to open up the second half here, Nate, because this drive, this is definitely a statement drive.
Absolutely.
Put this one a little bit closer in reach and continue to cut away at that deficit.
Bogner fakes the handoff, rolls to his left, now rolls to the right, now looking
Chiefs
downfield.
Is on the
he's
run.
Gonna keep it, and he takes off, and he swung down by his shoulder pads by big number 65, Noah Kubitz. Second down and about seven coming up. Ball at the 48-yard line. Warriors trying to make something happen here on this offensive possession as they were.
And what a beautiful night and what a beautiful picture. Thanks to our cameraman, Bailey Mullins.
Yeah, he's really killing
zooming
it.
Zooming in on the action
job
for you. Bringing this one into your living room as Bogner comes into your living room as a sea of red closes on the quarterback.
Third down coming up here for Hopewell-Loudon, or for the Mohawk Warriors at the 48-yard line.
Little bit
still
of that
inside their own territory.
A little bit of that frustration starting to rear its head. Mohawk successful in that third and 12 conversion to move the chains. Here on third and 7, much more manageable, but still Hopewell-Loudon doesn't give an inch. Digging their feet in. We're going to get a timeout to start this half.
Timeout Warriors.
As both squads didn't really need a timeout. Everything was kind of, well, I don't think Mohawk had enough timeouts in that first half as everything was falling apart and Coach Calatrulia was just riding the wave. There towards that end of that first half, you know, Mohawk with a huge turnover. I mean, they took that into the locker room with them. You had to come out with a completely different head on your shoulders than had it just been a 14-point ball game, Nate.
Yeah, absolutely, Tommy.
Now we're going to get underway with this huge third and 7. 9:24 remaining here in the third quarter of action right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Bogner in the gun.
Drops back to pass.
Oh, and he's met from behind. And the Chieftains gobble him up in the backfield. I think that was number 50 on the sack.
Big number 50, Braylon Smith coming in there to make the stop. And this is going to be a fourth and long. Fourth. At about 14, they're going to bring out the punt unit here. Braden Chester on to punt for the Warriors. And that punt will roll out of bounds right around the 20-yard line. Nicely done there by Chester. He's had a couple of nice boots there, Tommy.
Oh, man.
That's how you keep him in the game, but they got to get some offense going here.
Yeah, Mohawk trying to bring the paddles out, but the Chieftains pulled the plug on that drive in a quick fashion on that huge third and 7 play that stalled out right around midfield, forcing the Warriors to punt the ball. Now the Chieftains are going to come out for their opening drive here in the second half. Hand off to Willie to begin the thing. Still on his feet. Still tumbling forward. Good Lord. Caden Willie, Mr. Plow.
Rumbling. Stumbling. What a beast. 8-yard gain there by Willie. Sets him up with a second and 2. Ball at the 30-yard line.
That's when you could take control of a ball game, Nate. When you're a bruising running back, as you see in Caden Willie, when you can punish defenses with that bruising run, being up 21-0. You can control the pace of the game, continue to work your offense, and you're not saddled with a time limit. Ah, making some moves.
And that'll be good enough for a first down.
I didn't get a number. I couldn't see who was on the carry there.
Braylon Martinez on the carry.
Well, normally, if you see a big play, I could just guess Martinez and probably be right 90% of the time.
Well, the 10% would be Hayden Welling.
I'll play those odds. You can play the odds on Wednesdays right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Joey Krajewski and Aaron Steyer. The Over-Under podcast here on Wednesdays on Heart of Ohio Sports.
Welly picks up about 4, maybe 3 yards, up to about the 41. Actually, they'll spot it right at the 40. Chieftains looking to milk this clock, grind out the rest of this game. 6:53 left here in the third quarter. Still a lot of ball game to play here, folks.
And we want to thank you for joining us here on the Adrenaline Stream as Heart of Ohio Sports continues its expanded coverage in the 2022 campaign. Nate, we talked about it last week. Huge week one for Heart of Ohio Sports. Two big games, an MMA fight, and then coming into week two, launching two streams that we can't thank you enough for joining us on. As, again, if you got friends that go to Calvert, you know, you could tell them their game's playing, too, over there on the X stream on the second YouTube. But, man, the big game right here on the Adrenaline stream. You're watching it. Hopewell-Loudon with a commanding lead, 21-0, and continuously turning away Mohawk here in the second half as Mohawk came out on the opening drive, wasn't able to get anything going, resulted in a punt. And now Hopewell-Loudon has set up shop here. It's really taken over once again.
Yeah. Second down and 7. Braylon Martinez keeps it off the right side. Carries it forward. Carries defenders with him down to the 45-yard line. What a bruising run there by the 5'8", 150-pound quarterback.
Yeah, the way he was moving and juking down there, looking like a Jedi carrying Yoda on his back with those defenders through the Dagobah system.
They say he's 5'10 on the roster. We'll say he's 5'10. I don't want to cheat him those 2 inches, you know? Hand off Welly, left side. Bounces off a tackler, but there's another one there to clean him up at the end of the play. Nice job to get in there by number 20. Trevor Johnson. Got a fourth down coming up here for Hopewell-Loudon, and I think we're going to see the punt unit here, Tommy.
Nice stand by the Warriors.
I think it's the first time we've seen the punt unit on the field today, isn't it?
Yeah, not outside of turnover.
Evan Kreese back to punt. Gets the punt away, just barely. There's a couple guys right in there. This one, nice roll all the way inside the 10-yard line, right down. Actually, it'll die right at the 10, so well done there.
Not too sure that shouldn't have been downed earlier, but again, they have the best look at it.
A great job there by Kreese as he pins it down at the 10-yard line. That's where Mohawk will take over.
It doesn't get any easier for the Warriors, does it?
No.
Still down 21-0. Defense shoring up. You know, again, even though that 21-0 lead might not dictate it, some of those field positions and flipping the field, all that was a result of turnovers, Nate, to where, you know, Hopewell-Loudon not only found themselves with great scoring opportunities, but really commanded almost every drive that they've started from. It just so happened the ball bounced their way to where they've had great field position almost every drive.
Yeah.
They back being Hopewell-Loudon.
Ah! Nice throw over the middle. Bogner completes it to Zayden Fry. And he's got it down to the 25, maybe the 26-yard line. That's a good for 16 yards there on first down. And those are the kind of plays they need more of, Tommy. We need to see more of that out of this offense.
Yeah, Mohawk now with a sustainable drive to start here. Got a lot of work to do. 4:55 remaining and rolling here from Bascom, Ohio. And Mohawk trying to chip away at this lead that in this hole and dig themselves out of this hole that they found themselves early in. Is that going to be another timeout by Mohawk, or is that on Hopewell? That's the second timeout that the Warriors have taken just in this second half. So, I mean, that's going to give them one in their back pocket for the remainder of this one.
We're going to go ahead and take one with them. You're tuned in right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, your premier financial institution in Seneca County since 1952. Your community, your legacy. Federally insured NCUA.
The action here. Mohawk has it at their own 26-yard line. Ogner in the shotgun formation, receiver on each side of the field here.
Those are tremendous quick-cut commercials done by our friends over there at Dead Shark Productions, Nate.
We'll tell you all about that partnership. Oh! Ogner hits, he throws. Oh, nearly intercepted. We're going to say maybe that was a fumble here. I think his arm was hit as he threw, but
I think it was forward pass.
They're
going to
say it was a forward pass. Dodged a bullet there, as I'm not sure if that was a forward pass. I think he got his arm as he was coming forward with it, but I don't know if the ball was still in his hand when it was coming forward.
Just the sword of Damocles continues to swing closer and closer to Mohawk as they try to dig themselves out of a sticky situation, and then on second down, once again, something happens to where the Mohawk Warriors are trying to make up ground, and that's just tremendous defense by the Chieftains here.
Bogner, back to pass, second and long.
Look at
in
the coverage.
Over the middle. Fry, nice reception. What a throw by Bogner, beating the coverage there. And Fry, what a catch there. Another first down.
Crease the defender, reading Bogner like a book. But Bogner, head on a swivel, being able to make that throw, especially in the coverage. Wow, what concentration.
And he's been on the run almost all night, Tommy.
Yeah.
He hasn't had a chance to really step back in that pocket and set his feet and throw.
And a lot of that's, some of that's by design. For the most part, it's just been Hopewell-Loudon grinding it out down there in the trenches.
Bogner takes the snap, handoff.
Bring down that
Fry,
4-4.
Up the middle, into the open. Fry, stiff arm, 40, 35, 30. The cut down inside the 25. What a run by Zayden Fry.
Well, what is Mohawk going to do with that? You got yourself within striking distance. You got to get points on the board. You cannot come away with this possession empty-handed. 3:56 remaining here in the third quarter.
I sent it down to Eric Hall, our sideline guy. Eric, you had a pretty good look at that. Boy, that line kind of parted like the Red Sea there.
Yeah, and did you?
I'm sorry. Did you see what?
Did you see that stiff arm, Nate? That was
nasty,
a heck of a stiff.
Nasty stiff arm. And now Fry in at the quarterback position. Middle reverse. Now they're going to throw it down the field.
It's
picked off. Intercepted by Hopewell-Loudon at the 10-yard line.
They try to get cute.
A little trickery there.
And the Chieftains were not going to be falling for it. Oh, my goodness, again. You come up with a huge play, then you try to capitalize on that quick little swing of momentum, but it results in a turnover, and that just takes the wind out of your sails, Nate.
That is that's a backbreaker right there.
Because
they just really had some momentum going there.
I just said you cannot come away empty-handed on that possession. And those bites of the apple that we continuously talking about, you're getting down to its core now. And just plowing ahead. Willie continued to establish the run game and his dominance with
Martinez
his fingerprints all
just,
over.
I mean, watching this kid run the ball, he's only 150 pounds, and I bet they weighed him when he was still in his pads. That kid carries defenders with him, Tommy. I mean, you talk about strength.
Yeah, low center
dynamite
of gravity.
Dynamite comes in small packages. Wow. An equipment issue here as referee tosses something towards the sideline. Once again, folks, one of our proud partners here with Heart of Ohio Sports, Benchwarmers Restaurant and Delivery. They are the home of streaming football. That's right. They will be streaming this game. So if you're at Benchwarmers, you're watching the game, hey, we appreciate you. We appreciate Benchwarmers.
And order that pretzel bacon cheeseburger right now.
Tommy, now you got my stomach all. I wonder if they deliver to Bascom. A little press box delivery here, maybe? I know they do deliver some of the best food in town. And I'll tell you, folks, if you haven't tried it yet, what's stopping you? What's holding you back?
Trevor Johnson tying up the ball carrier like a pretzel on that one. And already just third and two. I'm sitting here talking about pretzel cheesy burgers.
Shoo.
Staring at the
third and three. Martinez on the keeper off the left side. He's into the open. He's got some running room. And he's down near the 30-yard line. They'll mark him down right around the 28. But that's going to be good enough for a first down. That'll move the chains. 21-0, Hopewell-Loudon. 2:12 left to play here in the third quarter. That's enormous. Yeah. I mean, wow. I thought it was a tarantula at first. Jeez, it was huge. She's going to knock it on somebody in the crowd now. Yeah. Diesel Welly with a carry, about a yard, maybe two. Second down and eight coming up. 1:30 left to play here in the third quarter. We'll take a time and give a huge shout out to our partnership with Dead Shark Productions. Big shout out to Alex and Brady Debker. Heart of Ohio Sports has partnered with Dead Shark Productions to produce video commercials for our streams. That's right. This partnership means you will see high quality video commercials produced locally by one of the best video production crews in the area. Evan Kreese rolls to his right, slings it down the field, and it is incomplete. Tipped up into the air. Nice coverage on the play by the Warriors. Of course, if you or your business are trying to take your marketing plan to the next level, give me a call, 567-207-5041, or you can shoot me an email at nmullins@heartofohiosports.com. Let us customize a plan that works for you.
Right now, both players, Hopewell and Mohawk in a collision.
And Martinez is still down. Fry hobbled as he's trying to make his way over, but looks like he might be dealing with a cramping issue.
We'll step away for 1 second and go ahead and thank our sponsors that help bring high school football to you right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. We want to thank Rodgers Flowers, TPC Food Service, Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, MST Sauce Company, Phillips Electric, Xcaret Mexican Restaurant, First National Bank of Sycamore, Steinmetz Sign and Graphic Inc., Benchwarmers Restaurant and Delivery, TJ Willie's Fine Foods, Feasel's Frame and Collision, Reno's Pizza and Pasta, Sara Risen, Century 21, Bolt and Tiffin, Embroidery and Crafts by Busia, Buckeye IT, Linda Ritzler Accounting, Culligan Water, Five Star Maintenance, Champs Barbershop, and the Advertiser-Tribune. Bringing you all the news locally, but I will be bringing you the fallout from week two this Monday night on the Pulse Podcast, airing live Mondays, 8 p.m., streaming on Heart of Ohio Sports and our YouTube page. Nate, just another tool in our arsenal to bring you that expanded coverage that we talked about.
That's right.
And then the coaches show on Tuesday.
Don't forget to look out for the Heart of Ohio Sports Observer next week. Written by Josh Morgan. Nice catch there. Jagger Endicott makes a move, and he's into Warrior territory. Down inside the 45 to the 44-yard line. Jagger Endicott moves like Jagger. Down to 52 seconds left to play here in the third quarter, and the Chieftains convert on a third and long there. And they move the chains, and now they're inside Warrior territory. Handoff,
Mohawk loading
right
the box.
Side, Welly carrying defenders with him as he makes his way down to the 37-yard line.
And just like the second drive for Hopewell-Loudon, just completely eating up this third quarter.
Yeah, right. That will be the final play of the third quarter. Your score, Hopewell-Loudon 21, Mohawk nothing. We'll step aside, take a timeout, we'll come back with the exciting conclusion of this ball game right here on the Pulse of the Buckeye State, Heart of Ohio Sports. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, your premier financial institution in Seneca County since 1952. Your community, your legacy. Federally insured NCUA.
Small business owners need somebody that can open the door to...
Sorry, Pat, didn't mean to cut you off there, but we got to get back here to the ball game as we have a... I think these referees, Tommy, might have dinner plans or something because, boy, they are on top of it. Let me tell you, the pace of this game has moved very quickly.
Yeah, not getting paid by the hour.
That's
here.
That's right.
Hopewell-Loudon continues to assert its stranglehold on this game. And a choke in the life out of it right now with this huge run.
10-5, and he's down right around the 5-yard line. Braylon Martinez, once again, a huge run. That's good for 40 yards. Actually, 38 yards. We'll give him... You know, I would say 40, but we'll give him 38 yards. What a huge pickup there by Braylon Martinez. Tommy, he's had his fingerprint all over this one.
Oh, absolutely. Dual threat in the backfield. You get threats there at the wideouts position. I mean, just these Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains, they're not quick. They're sudden.
That's right. Crease, handoff, Welly, left side. And a flag flies in from the back judge. Short gain on the play, but we'll see what the flag is here. Referees talk it over. I want to give a huge shout-out to our executive producer, Greg Kinn. Man, I'll tell you what, Tommy. He's got the nickname The Wizard for a reason. This guy has poured everything into it this week, really making sure that this The graphical content, the stream, everything is up to par. And you know Greg, Tommy, he's a perfectionist. Everything has to be just right. I can't appreciate what he does for us more, because I tell you, we wouldn't be able to do what we're doing without him. So big shout out to Greg Kinn. Can't thank him enough for everything he does for this brand. Of course, he's over there on the X stream, manning the technical aspects and also doing some color commentary with Zach Dillon and Connor Roush over there.
Lord help us.
And Lord help the Warriors here. Down 21-0 to begin the second quarter,
trickery
fourth
here
quarter
from the Chieftains. Kreese is tripped up from behind, but I'll tell you what.
Shoelace.
If Chester doesn't get him there, he's gone.
Absolutely.
Nice job there by Braden Chester. Just a shoelace tackle, like you said. 11:05 left to play here in the ballgame. 21-0 Hopewell-Loudon. Let's take a look around the area at the First National Bank of Sycamore scoreboard. Of course, over on the X stream, you can catch Calvert versus Monroeville as the Seneca's leading now 28-0. Faustoria, first game on the new turf over there at Faustoria at Kidwell Field. Kreese rolling out to the right, has to get rid of it, and he's able to get rid of it before he's brought down to the ground. Nice job there by Kreese. But Faustoria leading Seneca East in their first game on the new field turf, 13-12, that game in the fourth quarter. Clyde leading Holy Name, 20-19. Tiffin Columbian all over Springfield in the third quarter, 46-9.
Oh, that's a
good thing we weren't there.
Yeah.
We wouldn't have had anybody tuned in by this point. Sandusky and Lorraine, 21-7, your score. Sandusky leading. Huron all over Norwalk, 42-6. Elyria Catholic all over Perkins, 21-7.
Ooh, wow.
Fremont Ross, 51-0 on Toledo Start.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
That's a halftime score. Carey beating up on Galleon, 34-8. Throw into the end zone, touchdown! What a throw! Evan Kreese finds the receiver in the back of the end zone. Blake Barrier. And that's going to be a touchdown for the Chieftains. 27-0 is your score now with 10:30 to play here in the ballgame. What a throw.
Yeah, and he got the
I thought Greggy was calling again.
Touchdown maker down there on the field still. But you got to remember, Nate, we're still in August. Even though we've already covered two games in week one.
That's a little muggy.
We're week two. You're still going to have those cramping issues. You're still trying to adjust to game speed. I mean, it's a tough going if you're an athlete today. It really is.
Oof. Lakota taking it on the chin right now from Colonel Crawford. 42-3 is the score as the Eagles are all over Lakota. Carey beating up on Galleon. We said 34-8 is the score on that one. Gibsonburg beating up on Woodmore, 54-7. And Port Clinton getting a little revenge on Rossford after their week one loss to Bellevue. They're up 37-20.
You can also tune in to our games on www.heartofohiosports.com. And on that website, you'll also not only see links for the Heart of Ohio Sports Observer, but also you'll see the score stream set up there right in your face so you can keep up on all the scores in the area and in the state right there scrolling at the top of the screen. But, again, you're tuned in right here on our YouTube page and Facebook Live as live and in your living room, Hopewell-Loudon walks in for the two-point conversion.
29-0 your score, 10:30 to play here in the ballgame. And the Chieftains look like they're primed and ready for another deep run as they're getting tuned up here in this 2020 campaign.
About a 36-yard touchdown reception. And in that respect, you know, you're up 21-0 leading in the fourth. You've just been grinding on the squad all night. And then they just throw continuously work your offense, Nate. And that's what you do in your coach Brian Colatrulia.
That's right. Send it down to our sideline reporter, Eric Hall. As Eric's down there, he's got a pretty good view of everything. Boy, that touchdown pass, Eric, that was a beauty. Did you get a good look at that?
The pass was beautiful, and the catch was also beautiful. Did you see how he laid out for that?
Oh, what a catch. And, I mean, I think he had to stretch out a little far for that one because I think he cramped up a little bit afterwards.
Well, he got this hope.
Yeah, he got that crowd jacked up. They were pumped. That sideline went crazy.
They've been going all night.
Kickoff down to the 22-yard line. Returner brings it up to about the 32. 10-yard return there by number 26, Caleb Bish. The Warriors set to take over at their own 32-yard line, trailing 29 to nothing. 10:25 left here in the ballgame.
And when you mix a stellar performance against, you know, that unmatched potential with Mohawk, just everything going wrong for them tonight, this is how you get to this situation, how you get in this storm. 29 to nothing. Late into the game, trying to make something happen. You're just trying to get points on the board to see if your offense works right now.
Bogner slings it right side. That's complete. He's got it up to his receiver. Bryce Hannum makes the reception right around the 40-yard line.
Warriors on that
37-yard line.
Last drive, able to get down in the striking distance, but a huge turnover. Really spelled all the difference here late in the second half, Nate.
Warriors here, second down and four. Ball at their own 37. Bogner takes the snap, handoff up the middle. Johnson on the carry, and a short gain, maybe a yard. Trevor Johnson, the ball carrier. Actually, they'll say no gain. So set third down and four coming up. 9:30 to play in the ball game. Bogner in the shotgun formation. Three receivers on the far side of the field. Bogner rolls to his left. Sets up inside the pocket, and he's going to be brought down in the backfield. Nice job there by that big defensive line. Big number 70, Will Nutter. I think that's his second sack of the ballgame here, Tommy. He has been a monster on that defensive line. Will Nutter, of course, 6'3", 230 pounds. Hard to contain that kind of size.
Yeah, and it's starting to get bowling shoe ugly for the Warriors as they continue this part of that four-week road game stretch for the Warriors, and, you know,
Zayden
taking
Fry
that taking
point.
Their lumps early on in the season.
Gets that one away. It's down at the 40 and rolls inside the 30, down to about the 27-yard line. Hopewell-Loudon will take over there. First and 10. Once again, make sure you tune in on Monday as we bring you the Pulse podcast. That one coming to you live here on Heart of Ohio Sports, 8 o'clock this Monday night. Martinez going to keep it himself off the right side, and he's got about 5 yards, up to about the 33-yard line. Nice carry there by the sophomore. We'll have all the fallout from week one, and we'll get you set for Week two, I'm sorry. We won't have you set for week three, but week one of the Heidelberg football season comes to you next Saturday, right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Tommy, we got a busy week again next week. Jeez.
Yeah, Heart of Ohio.
One thing done and we get one thing put behind us, we got two more in front of us. I love it.
Heart of Ohio Sport joining the tricolor on the call for Heidelberg home football games this year and part on the OAC network.
And Hayden Welly buries his head forward. Yeah, and he's got it down to the 43-yard line for a first down.
I mean, have you ever seen more ways to tune into a game than spin a dial? You can get it. You can catch two streaming games on Heart of Ohio Sports, podcasts throughout the week to keep you updated on the local coverage. Then on Saturdays, you can get some college football in you as well.
Fake the handoff. Now Martinez trying to find some running room. Gets it up past the 45 up to about the 47-yard line. But, Tommy, the joy of what we do is you can take it with you wherever you go. You don't have to have it on a radio. You don't have to, you know, tune in on an AM radio or an FM radio. You don't need to worry about that. Everybody has a phone now, right? When's the last time you met somebody and they didn't have a smartphone? I can't even think of it. It's been years. Everybody has a smartphone. You can take us with you wherever you go, folks. It's that easy.
And if you don't have one, you're probably sitting across the table on somebody looking at one. So
right, exactly.
Hop in on the watch party.
Hayden Welly on the carry. Short gain. Maybe a yard or two. Boy, Tommy, there's a lot of key contributors here for this Chieftains team. It's going to be hard to pick a MST Sauce Company player of the game. I'm already kind of thinking about it. I'm like, who would I even pick here? Because I'll tell you, man, there's a lot of talented kids out there that are playing their butts off tonight.
I just hope that these guys aren't going to reject our player of the game award and try to hold us up for them MST rub ball right chips.
You know, Chase did say that the winner of – oh, here we go. Pedro Martinez.
He heard the MST.
He heard the
toss rub, dry rub, ball right chips. He's like, I'm going to get me a bag of them.
That's right. Those dry rub chips, I'm telling you, they're flying. They're flying off the shelves like nothing.
Them bussing.
The first week that they made those chips, ball rights told Chase – they sold more of his chips than all of their other brand flavors combined. Just outstanding.
Just the bell of the ball is old Chase.
First and 10, ball at the 33. 4:55 left to play in the ballgame. Crease takes the snap, handoff to Welly up the middle. And he buries his head forward for a couple of yards.
And Welly, he's dancing. Carrying a few defenders with him. Twirl them all around the floor. That's what they invented dancing for. And stick around for the post game here tonight as we'll have Eric Hall down there on the sideline try to grab Coach Colatrulio. He's standing right in front of him there in that gray shirt when he, at the conclusion of this one, or maybe an interview with Coach Eric Daniels, depending on the how these last 4 minutes play out. But Martinez continues this drive for the Chieftains, Nate.
Just keeps plugging away.
Again, that post game will be presented by your Legacy Federal Credit Union. Bringing you that post game each and every week here on Heart of Ohio Sports, and we can't thank them enough.
So third and five, third and about six.
Warriors continuing to have to play into the hands of the Chieftains.
Crease pitches it out left side. That's incomplete. He was trying to find barrier there.
That was a bright spot. Now it forced Hopewell-Loudon into a precarious position. That's the one thing you can't discredit this Warrior defense for. I mean, yeah, you're down 29 to nothing.
Yeah.
But how many fourth down situations has this defense put Hopewell-Loudon end to where, you know, there was just a communication breakdown or some kind of turnover occurred to where, you know, just a few different bounces of the ball could have completely changed the complexion of this game as Mohawk continues to try to live up to its potential. But as I always say, Nate, you lose with potential, you win with performance, and that's what right. Mohawk has to figure out here as week two continues to dwindle away.
Fourth down conversion incomplete. That'll turn the ball over on downs back to the Warriors. They'll take over at their own 29. Braylon Martinez, the intended receiver there. Yeah. 29-0 your score. Hopewell-Loudon leading. 3:14 left to play here in the ballgame. And we got a timeout here. Too many men on the field, I think, for Hopewell.
Too many men on the field there for Hopewell. And too many sponsors for us to just list off. So we'll take a quick second here to thank our sponsors bringing you high school football right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. We want to thank Rodgers Flowers, TPC Food Service, Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, MST Sauce Company, Phillips Electric, Xcaret Mexican Restaurant, First National Bank of Sycamore, Steinmetz Signs and Graphic Inc., Benchwarmers Restaurant and Delivery, TJ Willies Fine Foods, Feasel's Frame and Collision, Reno's Pizza and Pasta, Sara Risen Century 21, Bolte and Tiffin, Embroidery and Craft by Busia, Buckeye IT, Linda Ritzler Accounting, Culligan Water, Five Star Maintenance, Champs Barbershop, and the Advertiser-Tribune. All helping bring you high school football each and every week right here on Heart of Ohio Sports. And you're watching the adrenaline stream. The Chieftains continue this 29-0 reign over the Warriors as the Warriors are just trying to get some points on the board and hold their head up after this one's over, Nate.
That's right. Down to 3 minutes to play. Make sure you stick around for the Your Legacy Federal Credit Union postgame show. It's going to be a tough one to call for this player of the game, Tommy. I think Braylon Martinez has played an outstanding game. Blake Barrier, another guy who's all over the field tonight.
Well, the Fireflies are out there for Mohawk on the visitor side. They're not going to go out quietly into that soft night, is it? Bogner tries to make something happen there. Pass intended for Bish.
Third down and seven coming up. About six.
It's also been one of the stories of this game, those down and those third and distance situations.
Yeah.
I don't remember ever seeing Mohawk have like a third and two.
You're actually right, Tomlin. They have faced a lot of third and long situations. Timeout on the field. We'll keep it right here with 2:26 left to play here in the ballgame. Folks, First National Bank of Sycamore is uniquely rooted in our communities. They proudly serving their customers since 1919. They have locations in Sycamore, Tiffin, New Regal, and McCutchensville. Member FDIC, an equal housing lender. If you're going out, you're going looking for a new car. Don't just go to the dealership first, folks. Go get pre-approved. I'm telling you, it's a lot easier when you walk into a dealership with that pre-approval rather than trying to see what you can do with the dealership. Most of the time, they're not trying to talk you into the best loan. As far as terms for you, see your friends at First National Bank of Sycamore. Tell them your friends at Heart of Ohio Sports sent you. Also, don't forget about Your Legacy Federal Credit Union. They've been a part of this community for 70 years. Member-driven financial cooperative, and are delighted to provide a personal touch to an often impersonal industry with a focus on respect and member satisfaction while caring for your financial needs. Stop at Your Legacy, located at 25 Schaefer Park Drive in Tiffin. Your community, your legacy. Federally insured NCUA. Hand off the left side. Jace Margroff on the carry. Just a gain of one on the play. That'll bring up fourth and four. to give a big shout out to another new sponsor with us, Reno's Pizza and Pasta, jumping on board with us this year. Reno's, home to some of the best pizza in Tiffin. Have you tried the all-new MST loaded chicken chunk pizza? Oh my goodness. And Chester gets the punt away. Once again, a nice punt by Braden Chester. He rolls this one all the way inside the 20 and down around the 15-yard line. Well done by Braden Chester. Boy, Tommy, that's about a 55-yard punt. It's from about the 30-yard line. Nice punt there by Braden Chester.
And Mohawk just looking not to have any salt poured in the wounds. Decided to elect a punt there with a minute and 30 seconds. And, again, this is just one that the Warriors will want to soon forget. Trying to get on the right track. And that's what I – that's the one thing that's frustrating is you see that these Warriors, they're battle-tested. They come out tough.
Mm-hmm.
It's just – you know, you got to get some experience under you and be able to shine on the big stage. And week one and two has been the big stage for the Warriors thus far as the Warriors clean them up. As they, you believe that Hopewell-Loudon's called off the dogs here.
Into the game now for Hopewell-Loudon, number 18 at the quarterback position, Lucas St. Gregory.
That was Ashton Boer's back.
Yeah, Ashton's about 5'9", but I think he's a little thicker. Down to 49 seconds left here in the ball game. This figures to be most likely one of the last plays of the game. Handoff up the middle, fumble on the ground, ball on the ground. And it looks like Warriors will recover. So the Warriors recover the ball at the 10-yard line. Chance to maybe put some points on the board here, Tommy. Avoid that goose egg.
Yeah, do something. You know, get some points on the board.
Some mishandled handoff there in that situation.
We talked about it before. I mean, even sometimes when you fall on your face, you're still moving forward. And Hopewell, Mohawk has some positives they can take away from this game. But, I mean, they weren't going to be overshadowed by what Hopewell-Loudon's been able to accomplish here tonight in week two. After being on the same receiving end of the switch last week against Cary, coming out here in week two, Nate, and just establishing your identity, making a statement. What a tremendous win over a quality program.
Go, 32 seconds left. Bogner in the shotgun. Handoff up the middle. And it looks like they're going to possibly be close to a touchdown, but nope, just short. Bring him down about the 2-yard line.
Warriors better hurry up to the line. They burned all their timeouts earlier.
Trevor Johnson on the carry.
They
right at
points.
The 2-yard line. Down
you want
to 10
points,
seconds
you got
to
go in a 2-minute, man.
5 seconds. Bogner in the shotgun takes the snap. Handoff. Left side. And
that's the story of the game right
and
there.
And that's it. Just short of breaking
that's the
plane.
That's the story of this one.
The Chieftains hold on for the shutout and win here in front of the home crowd. 29-0 is your final score. Big win for Hopewell-Loudon. We're going to step aside and take a timeout. Folks, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with the postgame show brought to you by Your Legacy Federal Credit Union. And we'll have the player of the game brought to you by MST Sauce Company. That's all coming to you next right here on the Pulse of the Buckeye State, heart of Ohio sports. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, your premier financial institution in Seneca County since 1952. Your community, your legacy. Federally insured NCUA.
Small business owners need somebody that can open the door to financing. And at First National Bank of Sycamore, we love opening the door for financing opportunities.
All right, and we're back here. Nate Mullins, Tommy Hall in the press box here at Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains Stadium. We've got Eric Hall down on the sideline. He's waiting for our player of the game, and I think there's still some discussion to be had here, Tommy, because we couldn't quite figure out who we want to pick. We got a couple different guys that really played well today, and, you know, there's some guys on the offensive side of the ball. There's even a guy on the defensive side of the ball that I think really shined. But who you got? Who's your vote?
Well, again, you look at that score of 29-0. Hopewell-Loudon leaving an imprint on this one. That tells you about what you need to know on both sides of the ball. Just about a perfect game.
That's right.
Offense was able to click. But, again, I think the tempo, Hopewell-Loudon really set that pace, set that tempo early on, thanks to the hot hands of Martinez and Welly. Welly with two touchdowns. Martinez really was the tempo of the game on huge receptions that got Hopewell-Loudon down in the scoring situations. And my opinion, Martinez was the one that really really shined here in their debut at home here.
All right, well, we'll get him as our player of the game. We'll get an interview with him right after they finish the alma mater here, because they're going to, of course, sing to the home crowd. That's what they do after every victory here, victory or loss. After every game here at Hopewell-Loudon Stadium, the band sings to the football players, and the football players sing to the band. It's a great tradition here. Once again, thanks for tuning in here on the Your Legacy Federal Credit Union postgame show. Nate Mullins, Tommy Hall on the call. Great win for Hopewell-Loudon, 29-0 here in front of the home crowd. And we'll have our player of the game here shortly, as we're probably going to have to use our scoreboard camera so we can get a good angle here. But once again, Tommy, this is one of those games where, you know, not everybody likes a blowout. But a lot of positive things can be said about both teams here today. Obviously, you're looking at this game from a Hopewell perspective. Big time win. 29-0, 29 points, zero on that scoreboard. But for the Warriors, you know, this is another game that they can put behind them and that they can learn from, because you've got some positives to build on. They've got some talent. Now they need to figure out what they do well. What do they do best, and how do they play to their strengths from here?
One of those is by taking care of the ball.
Yeah.
Not giving up to turnovers. Defensively, I thought Mohawk came out pretty stout. I really thought that they took advantage of key situations, made strong stands when they needed to, and got a turnover. But that offense just came out flat.
Yeah.
Never got off the bus for the Warriors offense. And, you know, it's hard to play that one-sided for 48 minutes, Nate.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, we're going to step aside, take a quick timeout. We'll come back with our player of the game. And our sideline reporter, Eric Hall, is hunting him down as we speak. So I'm going to go ahead and step aside, take a quick timeout. We'll be back after this. You're tuned in right here on the pulse of the Buckeye State, heart of Ohio sports. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Yeah, if you don't mind, just go down one step, and you guys are good.
This is one of my first, too. This is my first year doing sideline reporting.
One step. Go down one step. There we go.
Let me just hang up with you, Nate.
That's perfect. No, you're good. All right. So, you're witnessing production as it happens. Nate Mullins, Tommy Hall on the call. But we have our player of the game, Braylon Martinez, here with our sideline reporter, Eric Hall. Go ahead, take it away.
Braylon, that was an awesome game today. It's a rivalry game. Last week started out, you started out hot and then kind of faded away. Had a little bit of disappointment, but we're able to get back on the win streak today. So how did that feel against a rivalry?
I don't know, it felt amazing. Considering that we fell apart in the fourth quarter last week. And that this week that we came and showed them out was awesome. Great yep. team effort.
You guys had a lot of energy down there on the sidelines. I was witnessing it. There was a little bit of a controversy here. We had Nate up here looking at your stats up here, and he says you're 5'10", 150, and he doesn't believe it. You got anything to say to Nate? I think you got the size.
Yeah, I'm pretty small. I mean, people don't take me for being a hard runner, but I always run hard for my team.
Absolutely. You were all over the place, man. You're listed at wide receiver and defensive back, but I saw you taking snaps. I saw you everywhere. And at the end of the game there, when it was still a shutout, I saw you down on the goal line down there. Did you have a little bit of added incentive to want to try to keep them out of the goal line, keep that a shutout?
Oh, yeah, you always want to have a shutout.
Absolutely.
If you don't have a shutout, then, I mean, it's still a win, but a shutout win is even bigger.
Heck, yeah.
You know, your defense stepped up the entire game.
Yep, statement win against a rivalry team. It's awesome. Well, you, like Nate said, you are our Madison Street player of the game. I think we've got a gift card for you. You got any favorites for Madison Street that you're going to use that gift card on?
Chunks. You know it.
It's always chunks, man.
Well, Braylon Martinez, he hit the nail on the head. Again, when he's giving the ball, he just plays his heart out,
game,
able to create the tempo, really
Can I get a picture
with you real quick?
Yeah, really responsible for establishing the tempo, establishing the pace that the Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains were able to establish early on.
Great game, man.
Great game in each facet of it. As that's Braylon Martinez, the MST Sauce player of the game.
Big-time performers make big-time plays in big-time situations. And you know what? Braylon Martinez is one of those big-time players. Once again, folks, post-game show brought to you by Your Legacy Federal Credit Union. I swear, every time we try to do that player of the game interview, we have camera problems. This time we had a camera right here, and as soon as I go to it, battery, dead. Are you kidding me this? Like, for real, every week it's something new, but hey, we're figuring it out as we go, folks, and we can't thank you enough for all of your support here on Heart of Ohio Sports. Once again, a big shout-out to the player of the game, Braylon Martinez, your MST Sauce Company player of the game. Tommy, I don't think anything more can be said about this one, man.
Yeah.
Great win.
Just, again, Hopewell-Loudon getting themselves in the win column. You know, you take your lumps early on. Use it as a learning curve, and you come back better, and that's exactly what Hopewell-Loudon was able to do here tonight. And that was the unfortunate thing about tonight's matchup, is one of these teams had to find themselves while the other one is going to have to wait another week to see what they can do to really start establishing an identity. The season's definitely not lost. We're in week two, ladies and
that's
gentlemen,
right,
of the high school season. So Mohawk, very quality opponents to start the season off, but I definitely see a favorable schedule in the future for the Mohawk Warriors. But complete dominance from the onset through four quarters, through 48 minutes. The Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains definitely controlled this one, Nate, as
from start to finish, Tommy.
Absolutely. Complete game by Coach Calatrullio and his Chieftain squad.
I want to take one more time to thank all of our sponsors here on Heart of Ohio Sports, because without them, we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be able to bring it to each and every one of you here on the pulse of the Buckeye State. Thanks to Rodgers Flowers, TPC Food Service, Your Legacy Federal Credit Union, MST Sauce Company, Phillips Electric, Xcaret Mexican Restaurant, First National Bank of Sycamore, Steinmetz Signs and Graphic Inc., Benchwarmers Restaurant and Delivery, TJ Willie's Fine Foods, Feasel's Frame and Collision, Reino's Pizza and Pasta, Sara, Reisen, Century 21, Bolte, and Tiffin, Embroidery and Crafts by Busia, Buckeye IT, Linda Ritzler Accounting, Culligan Water, Five Star Maintenance, Champs Barbershop, and the Advertiser-Tribune, all proud sponsors right here on the pulse of the Buckeye State, Heart of Ohio Sports. Folks, that's going to do it. For Bailey Mullins, our camera operator, Eric Hall, our sideline reporter, and, of course, Tommy Hall, the motorcycle maven, I'm Nate Mullins, signing off from Hopewell-Loudon Chieftains Stadium. Your final score, Chieftains 29, Mohawk 0. Thanks for tuning in right here on Heart of Ohio Sports.
Good night, everybody.